to record. Put you guys on mute. So we're gonna do a golden thread breath. I don't know if anyone has done that with me already. So it is quite a nice calming breath, relaxing breath, and it's an inhale in through the nose, and then it's literally just, you're just opening your mouth slightly and you're breathing through that. And they call it golden thread breath because you're imagining when you're doing this breathing technique that you've got a piece of golden thread and you're just literally blowing that golden thread out of your mouth. So it's a tiny little opening out of the mouth, inhaling through the nose. It's quite a nice sort of earthing, grounding breath as well. So a bit like the Ujjayi breath, the ocean breath that we've done. If we haven't, I'm sure we'll go hit that again. So it's quite a lot on sound, how it is, how you hear it, and then that pressure on that exhale. A lot of these breathing techniques are good for stressful situations, or situations that you need to be focusing on your breath, like labour. So you can use these breathing techniques in your birthing plan, that kind of thing, if you're thinking about what kind of breath you want to get used to. So they're really good to practice, especially even if you're, I don't know, in a queue of traffic and you find that things like that are quite stressful, practice those breathing techniques. And then when you're in a situation where you just want to gain a bit more focus, a bit more clarity, then focus on your breath. So we're just going to get ourselves seated nice and comfortably. So you can be sitting cross-legged like I am on a pillow, or you can sit with a pillow in between your legs and rest on your knees, or I'm just trying to think, any variation where you're comfortable. You can prop your knees up with pillows, you can lean against the sofa or something if you want some support for your back. Sometimes it gets a little bit tight and tension builds around that kind of, almost that bra strap area. That might just be me. But it's just where we hold a bit of tension. So bring yourself into that nice comfortable position. And close your eyes, drop your shoulders. And for the moment, we're not going to be doing our golden thread breath. We're just going to bring attention awareness to how we're seated, to our breath. Tune in to our body and just take a moment. So just be aware of your breath for now. Take a note of how fast it is, how slow it is. Try and allow your spine to be long and tall. So you might want to draw the crown of your head up a little bit. Again, drop your shoulders. And then you're going to take a nice inhale in through the nose. And your exhale out through the mouth with an open mouth this time. So like an exhale, like a big sigh. Inhale in through the nose. Another sigh as you exhale. And then this time taking your inhale, exhale, you're going to close your mouth and slightly open it. And breathe through pursed lips. Inhaling in through the nose. And exhaling out through that pursed lips. Now you can count your breath as you inhale. Carry on with that cycle. So inhaling in through the nose and then exhaling out through that small little opening of the mouth. Inhaling in through the nose. Exhale out bit like you're blowing through an imaginary straw. Keep that going. Two more breaths through that small opening. So golden thread breath, imagining you're blowing a little piece of golden thread out of your mouth. And if you want to exhale for longer than your inhale, that's absolutely fine. If that feels more natural, feel like you're expelling all of your air. Your heart rate actually slows down more on your exhale, like tiny, tiny amount. And then I just want you to find your own natural rhythm with your breath. Find a bit of comfort just sitting. Being aware of your surroundings, even with your eyes closed. Being aware of your breath, being aware of your body. And just trying to, even when something does distract you, just trying to stay in this moment. So stay in this stillness, stay with that connection with your breath. So anything that's going on around you, just kind of close your eyes, focus on your breath. And just building that practice, not having that reactive response anytime anything happens. And then slowly just drop your right ear over to your right shoulder. And then left ear up and over to the left. And then come back to center. And just move your shoulders, so shrug those shoulders up, shrink them down, circling them one direction, and then the other. So rolling them forward, rolling them back. And then allowing them to sink down. Draw that chin to your chest. And then slowly bring it back up. Again, dropping it over to the right. Up and over to the left. Back up to center. And then just bring your right hand behind you, left hand to right knee as you gently twist that torso round. If you've been stuck in one position today, it might be a little bit tight. Coming round to the left, so left hand behind you, right hand to left knee. Come back to centre. Then you're gonna interlace your hands, push your palms away, and then reach those arms up. Reaching up nice and tall. You're just gonna do a little bend over to the left. Trying to keep that bum down. So if it starts to lift, bring it back. You're staying in that side stretch. And then up and over to the right. I'm probably going in the opposite direction to you. Remember to breathe, don't hold your breath, and then come back to center. Release those hands. You're going to interlace them behind you and just draw them down to open up those shoulders. Oh, I've got a couple of cracks. And then release. Come forward into your tabletop position. And then just find yourself again in that tabletop position. You're always trying to find yourself with that flat back. So just check that your shoulders are over your wrists and then your hips are over your knees. And then you're just gonna literally move your hips a little bit down to the right, sweep your bum round and up to the left. So you're just circling your hips, keeping that focus on your hands if you can, just to not allow that neck to go too heavy. And then changing direction. There is literally no right or wrong. You're just moving around. You may want to change direction again. And then come to that tabletop position, keeping that back nice and flat. You might find that you just want to start to tilt that pelvis. Try not to. You really need to keep that lower back nice and strong. We're gonna push into our shoulders and then relax. So this time take a nice inhale. Exhale, push into those shoulders. Try and make a bit of space around the shoulder blades. And then come to a flat back. Don't tilt that pelvis. Take an inhale. Exhale, push into those shoulders. And then flat back. Start to walk your hands forward, melt that chest down into the earth, coming into your puppy pose or melting heart pose. So you're thinking about sinking that chest down, melting it into the earth, feeling that stretch around your shoulders. Doesn't matter how far down your chest gets to the earth, you're just conscious that you're keeping your hips over your knees. Keeping that breath nice and slow and your focus. And then slowly walk those hands up. Come to sit on your heels. And then you're going to bring one hand to your heart and one hand to baby. And just take a moment to check in. So drop your shoulders, draw the crown of your head up a line. That spine, get it nice and long. And as you take an inhale, just lift your heart. And as you exhale, we're going to just curl the shoulders, a bit like we did in that tabletop position. So making that space in between your shoulder blades. Inhale, lift that heart up. Exhale, curling your spine. Again, inhale, lift nice and slowly. Moving your shoulders, lifting your heart, slowly lower. This time, if you can, if you want to, coming up onto your knees. Knees. That was a combination of knee and heels. So inhale, lift that heart. Exhale, slowly lower that bottom back onto your heels. Just working those glutes a little bit. Curl those shoulders. Inhale, lift, coming up onto your knees. Exhale, slowly lowering your bottom, arching your back. One more time. Inhale, lift. Exhale, lower down. Curl round. And then release those hands either side. Just keeping that right hand by your right hip, you're gonna bring that left arm up and over. Sweep round in front of you. Left hand comes to left hip. Reach that right arm up. Sweep that hand round. If you can, lift your bum up again and bring that left arm up. Slowly lower those hips down, sweep that arm around, up, right arm is up as you come up onto your knees. Slowly lower, bring that left arm up, and then you're going to lower your hips over your heels, sitting down again. Walking those hands forward, back into that tabletop position. And just circle that right knee out to the side. Nice and slowly as you open up that hip, I'm only going as wide as your hip allows, and then reverse. Draw that knee back, and then bring it round, circling it. See if you can straighten it right back behind you. Finding your balance, flipping those left toes if you need to. If you can, peel that left arm up and straight in front of you. Taking an inhale, as you exhale, slowly lower that hand and that knee down. Inhale, lift that hand and that opposite foot behind you. Exhale, lower the hand and knee down. One more, inhale, lift, reach that left hand, push that foot away, and then slowly lower. Taking the left knee out to the side this time, just circle it. Try and do it nice and slowly, not rushing your movements, not rushing your breath. And then change directions, draw that knee back and bring it round to the side. Then you're going to take it straight back behind you. Flipping those right toes if you need that balance. Extend that right arm. Even if you're just peeling your hands off until you find that balance. Take an inhale, exhale, lower that hand and knee to the floor. Reach that hand and that foot away. And then slowly lower hand and knee to floor. One more, reaching forward, and then back. Flipping your toes, make your knees slightly wider. You're gonna walk your hands back. Start to lift your knees and come into your little yogi squat. So you might just be on the balls of your feet here. If you wanna practice going feet completely flat, you might find that you want to walk your feet slightly wider if your pelvis allows, and then you can drop your heels. Or you're putting blocks and cushions underneath your bottom to practice just coming into that yogi squat. Hands to the earth, slowly lifting your hips up to the sky, and then slowly peeling your hands up. Arms up overhead, take an inhale. Exhale, connect your palms. Hands to heart center. Slowly bending your knees, bringing your bottom down. Even if your heels lift, don't worry. Nice, that is our little variation of a sun salutation. Hands down to the floor. Bring yourself back into that tabletop position. And then walk your hands forward into your puppy pose. A bit like a variation of your downward dog, but not too much of an inversion. So you don't really want to be doing all this upside down stuff that we sometimes do in yoga whilst you're pregnant. So you're slowly drawing that chest down. Open up the shoulders. You can rest your head if it's allowing you to. It might be that you're not as far down as me, but don't worry. Just try and find a position where you can feel that stretch and find a little bit of comfort in it. On your next inhale, start to slowly walk those hands up into that tabletop position. You're coming onto your fingertips this time, so you're creating a bit more space in between your shoulders and your chest. You're going to bring your right foot through in between your hands. Keep your hands to the earth first. You might need to walk your foot a little bit further through, and then you're going to bring your hands to your knee. Again, if you've got any, you don't want to be stretching your pelvis too much, so you want to be listening to your body. So if it's painful, then don't bring that foot too far forward. Don't bring that knee over your toes. But you want to feel a little bit of stretch down this front left thigh. So keeping those hands on that knee to find that balance to start with. You can always flip these back toes if you need to. If you can, reach your arms up as you inhale. Grab hold of that left wrist and do a little bend over to the right as you exhale. Grab hold of that right wrist, coming over to the left. You might find you're a bit wobbly here, so don't go over too far if you are. And then back to center. Hands back to that knee. You're gonna start to straighten that right leg to come into your half splits. So your hands can be on the floor or on the wall. If you need that support, you can always get a couple of books. Some people have loads of encyclopedias laying around, or some little footstools just to have them to stretch that hamstring. So that right leg is straight. Keep that left hip over that left knee. And then you're gonna push your bottom away and just gently curl over as much as baby will allow. But as you push your bottom away, you'll feel that in your hamstring. Point your toes away from you and then draw those toes in towards your body. Pointing those toes away and then into your body. One more. Nice. Then you're going to start to bend that front knee. Come into those fingertips again, either side of that foot. You're going to take that right knee back and then bring your left foot through. So find that balance before you release. Move that foot further forward if you need to. Hands to that knee first. Find that position that is good and works for you. So if you want to shuffle that foot forward, and then you're going to inhale, sweep those arms up. Reaching up nice and tall, feel that stretch down the front of that right leg. Right wrist over to left, stretching over all the way down that right side. And then left wrist over to right. This is where you kind of lose your balance a little bit. Pretend you're trying to draw your thighs together to try and gain a little bit of stability. And then come back to center. Hands are going to come to the support that you need to come into your half splits. So whether you've got blocks, a table, or you might find that you're able to get to the floor, find that variation, check that that right hip is over that right knee. Push that bottom away, fold over as much as baby will allow. Point those toes away. And then draw those toes in towards your body. Point those toes away, and then in. One more. And then bend in that left knee, fingertips either side if you can, and then bringing that left knee back. Flatten those hands, flip your toes, coming back to your little yogi squat. So just might want to bring your knees slightly wider. Walk those hands towards those knees, coming onto the balls of your feet as your knees lift. Easy as that. Again, it's your choice whether you want to try this flat-footed pose. You can practice in your own time. Hands to the earth, slowly lift those hips up to the sky, curling all the way up, arms up overhead. You inhale. Connect those palms, hands to heart center as you exhale. Walking those feet underneath your hips. And then just curling your toes out. So stretching your toes, flattening your feet, and just checking that not all of your weight is in the balls of your feet or the heels. Dropping your shoulders, drawing the crown of your head up nice and tall. Just take a moment. And then you're going to inhale, sweep those arms up overhead to open your chest. So you're reaching your arms back and then over your head. Connect those palms, And then draw those hands to heart center. Two more, reach those arms up, back, and then overhead. Hands to heart center. Drop those shoulders as you draw those hands to heart center. Last one as you reach up overhead. Take an inhale, exhale, heart center. Release those arms by your side, finding your tree stance. So you're going to root that left foot into the earth first and find that tree position with that right foot. So either your toes are on the earth, heel is resting on your calf. Somewhere along that leg, you are going to find your tree position. So if you do want it on the inner thigh and you're wobbling all over the place, it might be that you just need to lower it to start with. Then if you can, you're going to bring hands to baby with yoni mudra. Yoni mudra is your thumb and your first finger together, almost like a diamond shape. Find a focus. And if you can, you're just going to look over your left shoulder. Super slowly. Even I am falling over. Right, I think I'm going to have to lower. And then bring those eyes back to center. And then start to look over your right shoulder. It might be that you follow this imaginary line all the way around the studio or your room. Come back to center. Oh. And then you're going to sweep those arms up over your head in Yoni Mudra. Take an inhale. And then controlled, you're going to release that leg out. A little bend over to the left. And then come back to center, release those hands by your side. You might want to shake that left leg out because even my little glutes were working there. So your right foot, you might find that your foot stance is slightly different on one side to the other. Find Yoni Mudra over baby. Drop your shoulders, draw the crown of your head up. Find that foot position that works for you. So whether that be toes on the floor, find that focus. Now you can stay with that focus, or with me, you can start to take a look over your right shoulder. Slowly coming back to center. I mean, my foot is going mental on the floor, wobbling around all over the place. Now we're going to look over to the left. So it's a real test of our balance. As you look over that left shoulder. If you do it nice and slowly, focus on your breath, come back to center. You might find that you don't wobble all over the place. Maybe it's just me, maybe I am just wobbling all over the place. Yoni Mudra, reach up to the sky, keeping that thumbs and first finger together above your head. With control, you are going to take that left leg out to the side. Bend over to the right just a little bit. And then come back to center. Release those hands by your side. Just walk those feet so that they're underneath your hips. Put them slightly together. Reach those arms up overhead. Connect those palms. As you inhale, exhale, slowly lower those hands to heart center. You're going to draw that right knee up in towards your chest. Again, a little bit of balance. If you want to hold onto a wall here, by all means you can. We're going to glide this foot back behind us. Nice and controlled. And we're going to let that foot land onto the floor. Coming into that stance, again, conscious that your pelvis and hips are not going to be stretched too much. That front knee is going to be bent. Just take that moment. If this is like you really hate this, just drop that back knee. Go back to that first position that we were in. If not, your hips are forward, your feet are forward. I mean, don't watch me because I'm all over the place tonight. I don't know what is going on. So, once you've found your stance, you're going to inhale, reach those arms up. Nice and tall, grab hold of that left wrist, Bring it over to the right, nice and slowly. Try and keep those hips forward, feet forward. So if you're going all the way over here and you're wobbling all over the place, bring it back. And then grab hold of that right wrist. Bring it over to the left. Feel that stretch all the way down the front of that thigh. Coming back to center. Release those hands by your side. You're going to start to straighten that front leg. If you can, start to lower that back heel onto the floor. Don't worry if you can't, if your heel's lifted, that's absolutely fine. But we're straightening our legs here, and we're going to fold over. Support yourself on a wall. If you've got those massive encyclopedias handy, you can grab one of those. So we're just stretching, folding forward, feeling that down the back of your hamstring. And then slowly lifting that chest up. A little bend into that left knee as you bring that right foot through to meet left foot. Take a nice reset here. So as we reset, we reach our arms up overhead. We center ourselves, connect those palms. Take an inhale, exhale, hands to heart center. Take a moment, check your feet. Are they underneath your hips? Good work, drop your shoulders. Lift that left knee up. Find that balance. And lift it up all the way. Even if you just need to peel that foot off, we're just practicing that balance. If you can, you're gonna glide that left foot back behind you, planting it down. Bending that front knee, hips forward, feet forward, front knee bent. Reach those arms up overhead. Take a nice inhale, grab hold of that left wrist, bring it over to the right. Grabbing hold of that right wrist, bring it over to the left. Coming back to center, hands by your side. All resting on your hips as you start to straighten that right leg. And if you can, start to lower that left heel to the floor. This way you start to fold forward as much as your body allows, almost pushing your bottom away again, holding on to whatever you need to find that balance. Allowing yourself to fold over as much as your body allows. And then slowly bringing yourself up. Bend into that right knee as you bring left foot through to meet right foot. Feet are going to go slightly wider than your hips now. And then you're slowly going to start to bend your knees to bring yourself down to the earth. Hands come down to support you. So as soon as they hit the floor, you feel that little bit of safety. Nice. Walk them forward. Bring those knees down. Keep wide knees, heels towards each other, toes towards each other, coming into child's pose. As you sink down your bottom and then walk those hands forward. Allowing that head to drop if you can. And then just taking that time as a reset. Slowing that breath down. Trying to keep that bottom resting on those heels. Keeping that focus on yourself. Walk those hands over to the left. And then you're going to bring that right hand on top of that left. Keeping that bottom down. A
And then walking them over to the right. Bringing that left hand on top of that right. Again, sink that chest down. Rest in your head if you can. Walk those hands back to center and slowly walking up, drawing those knees together, coming onto your bottom as you sweep your legs around. Your feet are going to be flat, knees are going to be bent, chest lifted. So your knees are going to be slightly wider than your hips, almost just the outside of your ribcage. Hands either side of your hips, behind you, and then you're going to drop your knees over to the right and turn your head to the left, gently twisting. And then up and over to the left, allow those hips to drop, turn your head to the right, gently twisting that spine. Coming up and over to the right. Here, if you want to, you can sweep this left arm up, come onto your knees and push your hips forward. So you push those hips, reach that arm up, or you can keep that bottom on the earth. And then slowly lower that bottom down if it's lifted. Left hand down, knees up and over to the left. So you're either staying with your knees down, looking in the opposite direction, or sweeping that right arm up, pushing your hips forward. Feeling that stretch all the way down the front again. One more each side. Bring those knees up and over, support yourself, sweep that arm up, push those hips. And then slowly lower over to the left. Arm lifted. And then coming back down. Soles of your feet together. And then we're going to be curling forward. So I want you to lift up. Imagine you're trying to reach up out your sit bones. And then fold over. And you can either interlace your hands around your toes. You can hold on to your ankles. Drawing that chin to your chest, just folding over. And here you might find that you're trying to find some comfort in that pelvis area. So if you want to draw your heels away from you or draw them into you. And then gently, we're just going to bounce those knees slightly. Just bringing gentle movement into those knees. And then slowly relax. Bring your chest up. We're going to gently twist round to the right. So that right hand's coming behind you. That left hand you can either put onto your feet or to that right knee as you twist round to the right. And then come round to the left. So either hand again onto that foot or onto that left knee as you twist that torso round. Back to center. Just crossing your feet. So moving the soles of your feet away from each other. If you are comfortable in a seated cross-legged position, or you can come with your heels, sitting on your heels. Just drop your shoulders again. Crown your head up nice and tall. And then we're just gonna circle the shoulders again. Either rolling them back or forward. Exaggerating that movement. And then allow them to sink down. Drop that right ear to that right shoulder, hopefully. Nice and relaxed now. Left ear to left shoulder. Coming back to center. And then slowly finding yourself into your Shavasana. So if you can lay on your back, you are more than welcome to bring a bend into your knees, put a cushion under your knees to support your lower back so that they're lifted. Or you need to be on your side if you are 30 weeks plus. You can prop yourself up with lots of cushions and blankets. So take a few moments to get yourself nice and comfortable. And your hands can either be resting on baby, or you can have your hands out to the side, opening up your chest. Closing your eyes if they haven't already been closed. And gently closing your mouth. Bringing that inhale and exhale through your nose if you can. But no worries if you can't. First, just bring that attention to your face. Try to relax any tension held around your jaw, your eyes, your mouth. Allow your tongue to drop to the bottom of your mouth. Check your neck and your shoulders. Releasing any tension. Just acknowledging it. Continuing to work down through your body. Checking your torso, your arms, your palms, belly, pelvis, bringing yourself into peace and ease and stillness. And like the beginning of class, just being aware and noticing your environment without moving or reacting. Just be aware of your breath as you inhale and exhale, aware of your body and the points of contact it has with the floor, aware of the sensations of the air on your skin. Noises that may be around you, sounds, smells,
noting your body move as you inhale and exhale. The rise and fall of your chest and your belly. The sensations as you inhale in through the nose and exhale out. Slower and deeper, breathing deeply, feeling your belly extend as you breathe in. Slowly moves with your inhale and exhale. Allowing the breath to relax you and relax your whole body. That feeling of peace and ease and stillness. Continue to breathe deeply. Continue to listen to all the sounds around you, faint and loud. Just focus your attentions inward. Focus on you. Focus on your breath. Feel your heart beating. Hear your breath. Maybe babies moving as you create this stillness. Just being aware and continue to breathe deeply and slowly. It's just taking that time to pay attention to yourself, tuning in to what it is that you'd really, really like to do. Creating stillness, peace and ease through every cell in your body. Your whole body breathing. Allowing the breath to fill up your whole body. Just feel and relax deeper. And even if your mind wanders, just acknowledge, be aware, continue to notice your body breathing, inhales and exhales, taking that time to connect with with yourself and with baby. Taking that time to release any tension. Allowing yourself to feel safe in this space. Stillness. Allow those breaths to get deeper and noisier as you settle further in to this stillness. You can go back to check in your face to make sure that no tension has crept in. Allow the tongue to drop to the bottom of your mouth. Be aware of your neck, shoulders, section, pelvis, thighs, knees, calves, and feet. Pressure to get moving, but sometimes we put too much pressure on ourselves. I must do this, we think, and I must do it better and faster. We begin to believe that only by worry and fear and pressuring ourselves can we get the job done. Whether the job is growing, making a particular decision, accomplishing a task, that kind of pressure doesn't get the job done any better or faster. It simply makes you tense and fearful and stops the creative juices. Too much pressure can take you out of the present moment. It can inhibit the life force, the flow of life within you. That kind of pressure can make so much noise in your mind that you can't hear your heart. We have responsibilities. We have time frames and commitments to others. And there are times when we need to get the job done. But the most pressing job can be done best when we're relaxed. The most urgent decision can be made most clearly when we're at peace. It doesn't help to force ourselves to go faster, be somewhere else, or be someone we're not. There are few things we need to do that can be enhanced by becoming tense, fearful, and worried. The more pressing the situation, the more pressing the need to be present for ourselves and to be present for each moment. Let off some steam, release your emotions, clear the pathway to the heart. The answer will come, the job will get done. Give yourself some relief. Take the pressure off. You can stay here for as long as you want to. or you can gently bring some movement into your fingers, your toes, wriggling them, stretching them out, bringing your arms up over your head, allowing your body to stretch. As you slowly start to bring movement into your body to feel energized and refreshed, bring yourself to a comfortable seated position. Aligning your spine, dropping your shoulders. Just taking a moment to be present, to be still, to be at peace. Reach your arms up over your head, connect your palms, seal that energy in, and then slowly draw your hands to heart center. May you feel safe and loved. And then bring your thumbs up to your third eye, that space in between your eyebrows. My soul honors your soul. Namaste. Thank you for joining me.